Good morning, students, and a very warm welcome to all of you in this e-learning session that is organized by Sri Gyanmancha Vidyapeeth. We have done session 1 for numericals. In the today's session, session 2 for numericals, we will discuss all the further formulas, and then we will move further for the numerical. At least we'll try to solve minimum 3 to 4 numericals today. Just have a look at the next particular part. First of all, we are doing the numerical where we have discussed already about all the formulas of area and the basic definitions with respect to the circle. Also, the content is over. Try to recall. Directly a shortcut was provided. Then next is speed. Directly write it as distance upon time, average speed, its total distance upon total time, velocity, that's displacement upon time. And average velocity, that is total displacement upon total time. Acceleration, final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. V is equals to u plus 80, s is equals to ut plus half 80 square, and v square minus u square is equals to 2as. V theta is equals to L by R, V is equals to omega R, omega is equals to theta upon T. One important thing that you have to note over here is this, that for object at rest or at stationary, you have to take the u as 0. If at all they have mentioned that the object is at rest, then you have to take initial velocity u as 0 in this all three equations of motion. These are all the formulas. Quickly note it. Just give the heading numericals and note it. Be quick in noting it. You have exactly 1 minute for the same, and then we'll move further with the sums. Be quick. We are being a little bit more now speedy. I hope that you are with me now. Okay, so I hope that the question is clear. The numericals are clear, and now we'll move further for the questions. We'll see today the numericals of distance displacement. Before we move further, one very important derivation, that is this. Conversion into SI unit. Always remember, before starting any numerical, convert each and everything into its SI unit. Kilometer or hour or list, forget about everything else and just keep one thing in your brain, that you have to convert everything into its SI unit. Everything needs to be converted in its basic SI unit. So 1 kilometer per hour will derive this is equals to how many meter per second. And every time whenever we are given the question in kilometer per hour, we have to convert it into meter per second. So we'll derive the shortcut for it, and reverse will be for 1 meter per second will be the reverse of this. Okay? You know that 1 kilometer is how many meter? It's 1000 meter. And 1 hour has how many seconds? 3600 seconds. So just divide the two. 1000 upon 3600. When you see two zeros, you know you get very good feeling. That is 00 Jojai, again 00 Jojai. Then this will go with 2 Faisa, 2 18za. So 1 kilometer per hour is 5 by 18 meter per second. This you have to remember. It's a key concept that 1 kilometer per hour is 5 by 18 meter per second. Very, very essential point. Note it quickly. You are having 1 minute for the same, for noting this content, and then we'll start with the sums. Last time we did it bit slowly because it was necessary for us to understand how the triangles and rectangles and that geometry part was there. So we went very slowly, and specifically we were discussing about that circular path, circular motion, which I had promised that I'll do it again for you. So it was done in the last lecture. Okay, I hope that it's clear. I hope you have noted that 1 kilometer per hour is 5 by 18 meter per second. Now we will move further for the numericals. If I come to numerical, then we were doing when distance and displacement. At that time, I had discussed with you about the linear path. And assuming that you are not facing, going to face any kind of problem, in that particular part, we are going to move further when the object is changing its path. Okay, only one example I had taken for considering the content of Pythagoras theorem. Today we will see two or more number of numericals. Okay, here the question is, a man moves 6 kilometer towards east and then 8 kilometer towards north. Calculate the distance and displacement of the man. So now always start from the origin. From origin you can see that the man is moving 6 kilometers towards east. Okay, is moving 6 kilometers over here, and then he moves 8 kilometers towards the north. 8 kilometers over here. Calculate the distance and displacement. Give this as the name AB. The distance is distance covered is 6 plus 8, that is 14 kilometers. Coming to the displacement, for the displacement you need to apply Pythagoras over here. This is a right angle triangle. The displacement is OB, and for that you need to apply this formula that OB square is equals to AB square plus OA square. That is 6 square plus 8 square, which is 36 plus 64, that is 100. So OB is square root of 100, which is 10 meter per second. Sorry, kilometer per. This is the displacement, so it is in kilometer. So the displacement OB comes to 10 kilometers. Note this question in 2 minutes quickly, then we'll move for the next particular part. I hope it's clear. Now we'll move further with the next particular question. I'm dictating the next question. You can say it. A circular track has the circumference of 3140 meters with AB as one of the diameter. So what it is given? A circular track with circumference as 3140 meters. The circumference of this circle is this, that is 3140 meters. So a circular track has the circumference of 3140 meters with AB as one of the diameter. So here you have to note AB as one of the diameter. Then a scooterist moves from A to B along the circular path. Find the distance and displacement. So this is about the question. The circumference is 3140 meters. scooterist first goes from A to B, in that case, you have to find out the distance and displacement. And the next particular thing that they have given is this, that what will be the displacement if he covers 3/4 of the circle. So let us assume the 3/4 is over here at point C. What if he covers 3/4 of circle? Okay. They have, in this question, they have not given you directly the radius. See, all these things are what I am trying to explain. You are having some concept. They have not given you directly the radius. They have given you circumference. So from circumference, first what you have to extract is radius. Then and only then you can do everything. It is easy for you to calculate the distance over here. But for the displacement, what do you need is radius. Object is moving on a circular path. Okay, it is covering half of the circle. Try to recall that table. In that table, half of the circle, the distance will be pi r, that is half of 3140. Okay, that is 1570. Displacement, it will be 2r, but for that you need r. Okay, next, what if he covers 3/4 of the circle? 3/4 means somewhere over here. You know whole circle, 2 pi r. But you want only pi r plus pi r by 2. So from that 2 pi r, you need to subtract this pi r by 2. And then for the rate, displacement, I have given you the shortcut for trick that for both the quadrants, whenever the displacement is asked, it's root 2 r. Okay. I hope you are trying to understand. If you have understood all the contents till day, this numerical is not at all hard for you. It's very easy for you and you don't need me to solve it. But because we are doing it for the first time, I'll solve it for you. If you have not understood what I said orally, then you can look over here. Otherwise, you can do it on your own, the numerical itself. Okay? And I hope that all of you will be doing the numerical on your own. But let's see, if you're not understanding, then I'm going to teach it. But I expect that you should know this. So this is about the circumference. From first circumference, we have to derive the radius. We know that the circumference is 3140 meter. Now what is the circumference? It's 2 pi r. That is 3140. Taking the value of pi as 3.14, okay. You will get the radius as 500 meter. So the radius is 500 meter. How I got the radius is 500 meter? So 2 pi r is 3140. 2 into pi k value is 3.14 into r. Try to recall, I said you that you can find the value of pi as 22/7 or 3.14. Here 314 is given. So it's easy for us if we consider this as 3.14. So r is equals to 3140 upon 2 into 3.14. That is 1000 upon 2. Once you divide 1000 by 2, what do you have? 500 meter. Okay. So you got the radius as 500 meter. Once you are getting the radius, things become very easy for you because you are having two particular paths. The path, distance, and displacement, right? The path is A to B. What is the distance? Half of 3140. Okay. So once you divide 3140 by 2, what do you have? 2 ones are 2, 1 1, 2 5s are 10, 1 4 2 7s are. So what do you have? 1570 meter as the distance. I am doing the mathematical calculation faster, otherwise physics is done aram se. Like, coming to the displacement, diametrically opposite ends, the displacement is 2r, so 2 multiplied by r, that is 500, which is 1000 meter. If you forget to write the unit over here, then your marks get cut it. Okay. So this is clear, I suppose. Now for the distance and the displacement when 3/4 are getting carried out. Okay, so for 3/4, what's A to B to C? This is the path. What is the distance? Try to apply the formula. It's 3/2. Okay, 3/2 pi r. Okay, because whole of the circle is 2 pi r. So it's 3/2 pi r. So 3/2 into pi is 3.14 into what is the radius? 500. Okay, just evaluate it. Multiply 3 and 3.14. If you just 3.14 can be written again as 314 upon 100. This will get cancelled out. Okay. So you are having 3 into 314 into 5 divided by 2. What is 5 threes are? 15 into 314 divided by 2. If we multiply 314 by 2, right now I am doing the multiplication over here, and then whole of the part will be rubbed. 314 multiply by 15, what will give you answer? 5 fours are 20, 5 ones are 5 plus 2, 7, 5 threes are 15, 0, 7 plus 4, 11, 5, 6, 7, 3 plus 1, 4, it's 4710. That also divided by 2. So once you divide 4710 by 2, what do you get? 2 3 5 4 7 10 divided by 2. 2 2s are 2 3s are 6. 2 5s are 10. 2 3 5 5. Okay, so this is how you get it as 2 3 5 5. So 3/2 r, it comes to 2 3 5 5 meter. Coming to the displacement of the same. This is clear, I suppose. Displacement, you know it is root 2r. No need to derive. Root 2 multiplied by r, value of r is 500. So 500 root 2 is the answer. Value of root 2 is 1.414. No need to substitute it, and this is how the numericals are done. If you know the table, they'll give you like this. They don't directly give you radius. Sometimes they twist this also and they give. Okay, note it down as in how very cleanly it is noted. Then we will move further with the next particular session, and you are having just 2 minutes to note it. After that, I'll start on with the Next, numerical. The next numerical is again a brain drilling numerical. I hope you have noted it. So we'll move further with the next particular numerical. We are going to discuss one pathway. Look over here. This is okay. You have done this kind of sum. Now, object goes as shown in the figure from point A to point D, and for this journey, object goes from point A to point D. This is the journey. You have to calculate the distance and displacement. So everything is in meter. 3, 4, 5. Calculate the distance and displacement. This is 6. It will be easy for you to solve it. Okay. So 3, 6, and 5 meter. Then you have to calculate the distance and displacement of the object. Now, what is the distance? Is very easy for you, right? Once the distance is asked, it's too easy for you. What's the distance? The distance is AB plus BC plus CD, that is 3 plus 6 plus 5. Okay? This is 11 plus 3, that comes to 14 meter. This is very easy. What about the displacement now? Can anyone try to think also what kind of things? This is outside the box question. The question where you need to apply your brain, you have to open up your all the strategies of solving any sum. Here you have to remember the first numerical lecture and the first lecture of motion. From that day onwards, I have said you, what is displacement? It's final position minus initial position. What is the final position? D. What's the initial one? A. If you want to go over there, what is this? Which is the shortest path? It's this. This is the shortest path. So you know that displacement is AD. Now you have to think, how can you find out this AD? You are clear that as per the definition, the displacement is AD. Some of my very lovely students, what do? They convert this 6, they divide this 6 into 2 parts, 3, 3, and then they continue. They apply Pythagoras over here, Pythagoras over here, and then add. No, you cannot divide this into 2 equal halves. This is what I am saying you is wrong. मैंने जो आपको अभी कहा ना कि बच्चे ऐसा करते हैं, तो वो जो करते हैं वो गलत करते हैं, मैंने ऐसे कहा आपको. द स्टूडेंट्स दोज हु आर ट्राइंग टू डू इट इन दिस वे, थ्री ओवर योर अप्लाई पाइथागोरस ओवर योर, अप्लाई पाइथागोरस ओवर योर एंड ऐड द टू, दैट इज अ रॉन्ग स्ट्रेटजी. ओके, वी कैन नॉट वेट आवर होल लाइफ टू डू न्यू मिस्टेक्स. समटाइम्स यू हैव टू लर्न फ्रॉम द मिस्टेक्स ऑफ द अदर्स. दिस इज द जनरल मिस्टेक दैट स्टूडेंट्स आर डूइंग. आई एम सेइंग यू दैट you don't have to go on this particular path, you have to go on the next particular type of path. Okay, I'm trying to say, just try to understand, just one particular line and the sum will be solved. But what is that one line? For that you have to apply your brain. Just I'm giving you 1 minute yet to think, just think. It's quite easy, quite easy. Just apply your brain. If you have done all the contents up till day and you are having the capacity to think outside the box, then you can do this. I am damn sure about it. Why I was emphasizing from the very first lecture of numerical on the basic types of triangles and rectangles and parallelograms formula is this reason. Because this should strike you. Almost 30 seconds are over, last 30 seconds. If it comes, then it's okay. And if it doesn't come, then I'm going to do it. Don't worry. I'm expecting many of you might have done it. Now, what you have to do is simply stretch this, stretch this. These are the opposite sides of rectangle. If this is 6, this will be 6. This is 3, this will be 3. This is what we have constructed. Actually, it wasn't there. This is what is constructed over here. So this is 6. This much is 3 plus 5. So what is 5 plus 3? It's 8 meter. Now apply the formula. Name this as suppose O. If you want to find out AD, then AD square is equal to AO square plus OD square, which is 6 square plus 8 square. What is 6 square? 36. 8 square is 64. What is 64 plus 36? It's 100. So AD is square root of 100, which is 10 meter. The displacement comes to 10 meter. Actually, it's not at all hard to calculate for 6 and 8. The answer is 10. Hard is this thinking part. Still, I'm saying you have to be cautious whenever you are doing the numerical. Each and everything is very, very, very easy. But it's in this manner. Okay, quickly note it. And the first diagram was without this. So note the diagram like this and after that draw that. You're having exactly 1 minute for copying it. Then we'll do the last numerical of the day. I hope you noted it. If not, then do take all the screenshots of the numericals once you do it and then audit it also. Sometimes you, sometimes we make the mistake, small mistake in one particular letter and then it becomes hard for us. So whenever you are revising back and that may come as a doubt. Expecting that, you have done this. One last numerical and then still all these are level 1 numericals. We are having 3 levels of numerical, level 1, level 2 and level 3. Level 1 numericals are the easy ones. This is easy one. Level 2 where we'll apply our brain a lot, and level 3, this will be based on all the exams that are of higher level, that is that will be helpful to you even for NEET JEE. Some of the questions from the previous years of that only, which are coming from the concepts of class 9. Okay, so we'll not do more number of numericals, but at least one lecture I'll take on level 3 based. Let's move further with the last numerical of the day. The object travels on a square path of length 10 meter from A to C as shown in figure. So this is a square path. Object is covering the path from A to C. Calculate distance and displacement. Second, in this only, if object covers or completes 3 rounds from A to A, then calculate distance and displacement. So 3 times we'll be going from A, 1 time, 2 time and 3rd time. You know that the path length, square of path, the object is traveling in the square path. And what is the length of the square side of the square? 10 meter. Now, first case, the object is going from A to C. So, in the very first case, what is the distance? 10 over here, it's square. So, this will be 10. So, 10 plus 10, what will be? 20. Second, displacement. This again is a Pythagoras, that is AC. How to get AC? AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square, 10 square plus 10 square, 100 plus 100, which is 200. So AC is equals to square root of 200. That is 10 into root 2. So the displacement is 10 root 2. Second answer, 3 rounds. One is of 10, another 10, another 10 and another 10. So for completing one particular whole square, it is taking how much distance it is traveling? 10 plus 10, 20, 30 plus 4, 40. So for the second case, the distance will be 3 rounds, so 3 into 40, 1 time 40, another time 40, 3rd time 40, 40 plus 40 plus 40, that is 120 meter over here, meter over here, meter over here. Here the displacement will be always a displacement from the point where it started at the same point it is ending. The beginning and the ending point is same, and so the displacement will be zero. Okay, it will be zero. So note it down. I'm giving you 1 minute. Quickly, just note it. Hope that you have written this, okay. And today again, now we'll depart as usual with a small quote that if life changes, if life becomes harder, change yourself to be stronger. That's all for the content of the day. I hope that you have understood all the numericals. From tomorrow, we are going to do further the numericals of speed, distance, speed, velocity, acceleration, and then equations of motion. So this is how we have categorized. First level 1, few days, 2-3 days, then level 2, then level 3. And that's all for the content of the day. And assuming that you have understood everything, I depart. Thank you and have a very good day, all of you. That's all. Bye-bye.